Welcome to USA Breaking News Today. Please subscribe and click notification box to get all breaking news alert.
Breaking news today. U.S. forces could remain in Syria as Donald Trump fought ILS to win backing for Arab Army. Donald Trump is struggling to gain backing from Arab countries to form an Arab military force to replace U.S. troops in Syria fighting ISIS, derailing his plans to reduce American military presence in the region. Allies including Saudi Arabia are skeptical about sending troops to Syria and contributing funds in order to stabilize towns and cities liberated from ISIS without U.S. support, according to senior U.S. officials. This is particularly the case for countries such as Saudi Arabia, which is already engaged militarily in Yemen. A senior U.S. official involved in discussions said, "There is no serious appetite in the region to do that much on the ground. One thing is certain, no other military, particularly from the region, will enter Syria if we are not there in some capacity." President Trump has previously said, "We have asked our partners to take greater responsibility for securing their home region, including contributing larger amounts of money." A U.S. administration official confirmed this statement, saying, "Saudi Arabia, Qatar, and the UAE have all been approached with respect to financial support and more broadly to contribute." Saudi Arabia's Foreign Minister Adel Jubeir also confirmed that his government has been in discussion with Washington since the beginning of the Syrian crisis about sending forces into Syria. There are currently around 2,000 U.S. troops in eastern Syria who are working alongside local fighters to defeat localized pockets of ISIS militants in towns and rural strongholds along the Euphrates River. President Trump has signaled that he desires U.S. troops to be removed very soon, despite fears of Iran's growing influence in the region. There are concerns that the U.S. may become trapped in Syria's multi-sided civil war and landed with the job of controlling ISIS in the long term. But this runs the risk of creating rifts in the Trump administration, as top U.S. officials are warning the White House that a hasty withdrawal from Syria could repeat the mistakes made by President Obama when he withdrew forces from Iraq in December 2011. Marine General Joseph Dunford, chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, said, "We learned that the Iraqi forces were incapable of providing security inside the country, and that gave the enemy an opportunity to resurge. That's where, really, ISIS had the space to grow." Defense Secretary James N. Mattis reaffirmed this statement, stating that the U.S. would probably regret not leaving troops in Syria in order to train local security forces to prevent the resurgence of ISIS. He also said, "We have to create local forces that can keep the pressure on any attempt by ISIS to try to regenerate." The Pentagon is reportedly developing plans to continue airstrikes and special operations against ISIS in Syria, while allowing U.S. ground troops to withdraw. U.S. officials said this would reassure Arab allies that the U.S. would not leave them unprotected in the region, and would contribute to the stabilization of the country despite the withdrawal of ground troops. Thanks for watch. Please share, like, comment this video and subscribe channel for latest news.